It's all good.
Thank you.
In the name of the Father, the Son, of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Forgive us all our afflictions, and that enables us to comfort those who are in trouble with the same consolation we have received from him. Now, I bless the body of our brother Antonio with the holy water that we call his baptism, of which St. Paul writes, "All of us were baptized into Christ Jesus, were baptized into his death. By baptism into his death, we were buried together with him, so that just as Christ was raised from the dead by the glory of the Father, we too might live a new life. For if we have been united with him by likeness to his death, so shall we be united with him by likeness to his resurrection." Thank you. Baptism, our brother Antonio put on Christ, on the day of Christ coming, may he be clothed with glory. Almighty God and Father, it is our certain faith that your Son, who died on the cross, was raised from the dead, the first fruit of all who have fallen asleep. God, through this mystery, your servant Antonio, who has gone to his rest in Christ, may share the joy of his resurrection. We have this through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever.
Amen.
My brothers and sisters, now please be seated. It is the time for the first reading.
morning, everybody. A time for everything. There is time for everything and a season for every activity under heaven. A time to be born and a time to die. A time to plant and a time to uproot. A time to kill and a time to heal. A time to tear down and a time to build. A time we weep and a time we laugh. A time we mourn and a time we dance. A time of scattered stones and a time to gather them. A time to embrace and a time to refrain from embarrassing. A time to search and a time to give up. A time to keep, the time to throw away. A time to tear and a time to mend. A time to be silent and a time to speak. A time to love and a time to hate. A time for war and time for peace. What do workers gain from their toil? I have seen the burden God has laid on a human, God has laid on the human race. He has made everything beautiful in its time. He has also set eternity in the human heart. Yet no one can fathom what God has done from beginning to the end. The word of God.
Thanks be to God.
And kindness shall follow me all the days. The Lord be with you.
A
reading from the Holy Gospel according to John. In that time, Jesus said to his disciples, "Everything that the Father gives me will come to me, and I will not reject anyone who comes to me, because I came down from heaven not to do my own will, but the will of the one who sent me. And this is the will of the one who sent me, that I should not lose anything of what he gave me, but that I should raise it on the last day. For this is the will of my Father, that everyone who sees the Son and believes in him may have eternal life, and I shall raise him on the last day." The Gospel of the Lord. Have a seat, my brothers and sisters. My deepest condolences to you, families and relatives and friends coming this morning to celebrate the eternal life of our brother Antonio. We are united with you today in sorrow at the death of our brother Antonio. I said eternal life because for us Christians, death is a passage from short life to eternal life. I know that the reality of death, with all its pain and sense of loss, confronts you at this moment. But as I stand here before you this morning, I know that we are also united with you in another way, namely faith. And you know, my brothers and sisters, if it were not for that faith, I would have very little to say to you that would be of any consolation or meaning. We have questions, of course. For some, Antonio's death will be a means of leading them to count their blessing, while for others, it may cause them to wonder and even doubt why a loving God would allow our brother Antonio died. Remember that, my brothers and sisters, God doesn't take life, rather, he gives us life. Yes, in the first reading, we heard that there was a time for everything. There was a time also for our brother Antonio to be born in Italy, and a time to come to Canada, spending his time among us, among his own family. There was a time for him to be a great dad, a great friend, a great nono, and a time to be a hardworking man, and many other wonderful things and experience with friends and family. E quindi, cari fratelli e sorelle, e questa persona, e questo uomo oggi, noi veniamo non per celebrare giustamente il suo funerale, ma come già vi ho detto, per celebrare la sua vita eterna. E a volte noi facciamo tante domande riguardo alla morte, perché noi non riusciamo a capire perché uno che camminava, mangiava, parlava con noi e adesso si trova in una condizione dove non può fare niente. A volte quando pensiamo a questa realtà e soprattutto quando noi pensiamo che nunca andremo a vedere questa persona appunto che era cara per noi, certamente anche noi abbiamo paura della morte. Perché? Perché giustamente non sappiamo in realtà che diventa questo fratello. Però, cari fratelli e sorelle, è vero che la morte può causare paura, è vero che l'amore può causare un distacco, però noi appoggiamo la nostra fede sopra la morte di Gesù ed anche la sua resurrezione. È lui appunto che ci fa capire che la morte non è un fenomeno che finisce con la nostra vita, ma la morte è qualcosa, un fenomeno che cambia la nostra vita. E quindi questa vita, possiamo dire, corta a questa vita eterna. Ed è per questo motivo, sin dall'inizio ho detto, siamo radunati qui per celebrare la vita eterna di questo nostro fratello Antonio. Yes, my brothers and sisters, we gather this morning with a mixture of grief and optimism. Grief because someone you love and who love you is no longer here for you to hold close and speak with. And optimism because we all know how Antonio prepared himself to meet God, his father. Because of Antonio's faith in God's promise, we have good reason to hope that he will stand before God today, rejoicing in the wedding feast of heaven in praying for us. Sì, cari fratelli e sorelle, questa è la nostra fede ed anche la nostra speranza. È proprio da questa speranza che noi giustamente crediamo che Antonio adesso sta nelle mani di Dio. Certamente lui ha preparato questo giorno, ma anche è un momento importante per noi, per preparare anche il nostro giorno. Perché? Perché giustamente un giorno andremo a fare la stessa esperienza, l'esperienza di incontrare Dio faccia a faccia. But today is a day to remember God's promises to Antonio and to pray for the repose of his soul. And you know, funerals are not only for those who have passed away, but for the living who stay behind. So there is no doubt that Antonio's life and death had have a profound influence for good on an enormous number of people, especially his own family. But as we leave him lovingly with the Lord today, we can be consoled by the scriptures we have just heard. You know, today, Jesus says, I will come to take with me all of those that the Father gave me. So my brothers and sisters, Antonio, since the day of his baptism, he became God's son. That's why he was for God. And today, Jesus came to take him with him in order to taste the paradise he was preparing during his life. Cari fratelli e sorelle, in questa messa, dove noi stiamo celebrando la vita eterna di Antonio, andiamo a chiedere al Signore di darci anche il coraggio di supportare questa morte, ma anche di dare coraggio di pregare per lui, anche lui pregare per noi che siamo in peregrinaggio qua giù. Perché quando il Signore viene a toccare la nostra porta, anche noi possiamo essere pronti per fare questo viaggio. E quindi, cari fratelli e sorelle, ed è per questo motivo, noi siamo invitati ogni giorno a rinnovare la nostra relazione con il Signore, a rinnovare il nostro rapporto con il Signore, a ponerlo come giustamente il centro della nostra vita cristiana. Antonio, giustamente durante la sua vita, ha messo il Signore come il centro della sua vita ed è per questo motivo adesso lui è nelle mani del Signore. The Church reminds us every day that the Eucharist is the foretaste of this heavenly banquet. The Eucharist, of course, was at the heart of Antonio's life. So today, in this special moment, where our brother Antonio contemplates God face to face, let us celebrate together with him. In the Eucharist, we are united through the Lord with our Father in heaven, united not just with one another, but of all those who have gone before us. And now, may our brother Antonio take his place among the elect at the heavenly banquet and pray for us. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. God the Almighty Father, who has raised his Son from the dead, with confidence, we ask him to save all his people, living and dead.
Prayers of the Faithful. God the Almighty Father, raised Christ his Son from the dead. With confidence, we ask him to save all his people, living and dead. For whom in baptism was given the pledge to eternal life, that he may now be admitted to the company of the saint. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our
prayers. For our deceased relatives and friends, and for all who have helped us, that they may have a reward of their goodness, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
For those who have fallen asleep in the hope of rising again, that they may see God face to face, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
For the family and friends of Tony Moro, that they may be consoled in their grief by the Lord, who wept at the death of his friend Lazarus, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all of us assembled here to worship in faith, that we may be gathered together again in God's kingdom, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Let us pray. God, our shield and our strength, you listen in love the cry of your people. Hear the prayers we offer for our deceased brother Antonio. Cleanse him of his sins and grant him the fullness of redemption. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Please be seated.
Thank you.
My brothers and sisters, may my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and of all his holy church.
O Lord, look in favor upon the gifts we offer on behalf of the soul of your servant Antonio, and purify him through your divine healing so that he may find rest in your love through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts, please stand. Let us give thanks, Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty in all salvation, always and everywhere, to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. In him the hope of blessed resurrection has dawned, that those saddened by the certainty of dying might be consoled by the promise of immortality to come. Indeed, for your faithful Lord, life is changed, not ended. And when his heavenly dwelling turns to dust, an eternal dwelling is made ready for them in heaven. And so with angels and archangels, with thrones and dominions, with all hosts and powers of heaven, we sing the hymn of your glory, as without end we acclaim. By the power and working of the Holy Spirit, you give life to all things and make them holy, and you never cease to gather a people to yourself so that from the rising of the sun to its setting, a pure sacrifice may be offered to your name. Therefore, O Lord, we humbly implore you, by the same Spirit, graciously make holy these gifts we have brought to you for consecration, that they may become the body and blood of your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, at whose coming we celebrate these mysteries. For on the night he was betrayed, he himself took bread and, giving you thanks, he said the blessing, broke the bread and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice and, giving you thanks, he said the blessing and gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. Therefore, O Lord, as we celebrate the memorial of the saving passion of your Son, his resurrection and ascension into heaven, and as we look forward to his second coming, we offer you in thanksgiving this holy and living sacrifice. Look, we pray, upon the oblation of your church, recognizing the sacrificial victim by whose death you will to reconcile us to yourself.
whether we were nourished by the body and blood of your Son, and filled with his Holy Spirit, may become one body, one spirit in Christ. May he make of us an eternal offering to you, so that we may obtain inheritance with your elect, especially with the most blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with blessed Joseph, her spouse, with your blessed apostles and all inglorious martyrs, and with all the saints, on whose constant intercession in your presence we will live for unfailing help. May the sacrifice of our reconciliation, we pray, O Lord, advance the peace and salvation of all the world. Be pleased to confirm in faith and in charity your pilgrim church on earth, with your servant Francis, our Pope, and Michael, our Bishop, the other bishops, all the clergy, and the entire people you have gained for your own. Listen graciously to the prayers of this family, whom you have summoned before you. In your compassion, O merciful Father, gather to yourself all your children scattered throughout the world. Remember your servant, Antonio, whom you have called today from this world to yourself. God, that he who was united with your Son in a death like his may also be one with him in his resurrection. When from the earth, he will raise up in the flesh those who have died after the burden of his own glorious body. To all the departed brothers and sisters too, and to all who are pleasing to you, at their passing from this life, give God admittance to your kingdom. There we hope to enjoy forever the fullness of your glory, when you will wipe away every tear from our eyes. For seeing you, our God, as you are, we shall be like you for all the ages, and praise you without end, through Christ our Lord, through whom you bestow on the world all that is good. Through him, and with him, and him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Amen. Obediente alla parola del Salvatore, e formati al suo divino insegnamento, osiamo dire: Padre nostro, che sei nei cieli, sia santificato il tuo nome, venga il tuo regno, sia fatta la tua volontà, come in cielo, così in terra. Dacci oggi il nostro pane quotidiano, e rimetti a noi i nostri debiti, come noi rimettiamo i nostri debitori, e non ci indurre in tentazione, ma liberaci dal male. Liberaci, o Signore, da tutti i mali, concedi la pace ai nostri giorni, e con l'aura della tua misericordia, saremo sempre liberi dal peccato e sicuri da ogni turbamento, nell'attesa che si compia la vera speranza e venga il nostro Salvatore Gesù Cristo.
Tu è il regno, tu è la potenza e la gloria nei secoli.
Signore Gesù Cristo, che hai detto ai tuoi apostoli, vi lascio la pace per la mia pace, non guardi ai nostri peccati, ma la fede della tua Chiesa, e non hai unità e pace secondo la tua volontà, tu che vivi e regni nei secoli dei secoli.
Amen.
La pace del Signore sia sempre con voi. Cari fratelli e sorelle, scambiatevi un segno di pace.
Pace a voi, pace a voi, pace a voi, pace a voi, pace a voi.
Beati gli invitati alla cena del Signore, ecco l'agnello di Dio che toglie i peccati del mondo.
Signore, non sono degno di partecipare alla tua messa, ma è soltanto una parola, e io sarò salvato.
Let us pray. Almighty God, may the sacrifice purify the soul of your servant Antonio, which has departed from the world today, but at once delivered from his sins, he may receive forgiveness and eternal rest through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Now, my brothers and sisters, please be seated. Our loved one from the family will express some words on behalf of our Lord Antonio. This is the time for the eulogy.
I don't know if I can do this, but I'm going to try. Friends and family, thank you so much for being here with us today. We are absolutely devastated to have lost such a beautiful soul. But right now, we ask we take a collective moment together and celebrate the truly incredible man that Tony was. There is so much to say, but how do we sum it up? A lifetime in just a few words of a man who was so abundantly larger than life. We gather here today to celebrate the life of Tony Morrow, a man whose journey from humble beginnings to remarkable success exemplifies the spirit of resilience and generosity. Tony arrived in this country from Calabria, Italia, with nothing but a dream and a steadfast determination. His story began with a boat ride, a voyage that carried not just his body, but also his aspirations and hopes. From these modest beginnings, he built a restaurant that became more than just a place to eat. It was a beacon of his hard work, perseverance, and dedication. Tony's success was not measured merely by prosperity of his business, but by the kindness and charity that defined his character. Despite the challenges he faced, he never lost sight of the importance of giving back. He used his success to support those in need, generously contributing to various charitable causes and embodying the very essence of selflessness. His legacy extends beyond the walls of his restaurant. It lives on in the countless lives he touched through his acts of kindness and the example he set for all of us. Tony Morrow taught us that true success is not just about what was achieved for ourselves, but also about how we use our blessings to uplift others. Today, as we remember Tony, let us honor his life by carrying forward his values of hard work, generosity, and compassion. Though he may no longer be with us, his spirit and the impact he made will continue to inspire us. Rest in peace, Tony Morrow. Your life was a testament to the power of dreams and the importance of giving. You will be deeply missed, but fondly remembered. Through our tears, let us see the blessings of knowing and loving you, a great a noble man, and the best father, grandfather, brother, and uncle. Thank you. Sorry, this is gross.
Thank you.
faith was strong, but you needed proof. You saw her bathing on the roof, her beauty in the moonlight overthrew you. She tied you to her kitchen chair, she broke your throne, she cut your hair, and from your lips she drew a hallelujah.
Ladies and gentlemen, immediately following Mass, we'll be making our way to Forest Lawn Memorial Park for the interment. Everyone is welcome to attend if you would like. Following that, the family has invited everyone to the Italian Cultural Center for lunch. Once again, we'd like to see everyone join if you can. There will be a time for condolences at the Cultural Center. The family has declined to do condolences here at the church after Mass. Thank you very much.
È diventato figlio di Dio e tante volte si è nutrito alla mensa del Signore, sia ora accolto nei cieli al banchiere dei fedeli e con i santi sia erede dei beni eterni promessi. E anche per noi che sentiamo la tristezza di questo distacco, supplichiamo il Signore perché possiamo un giorno, insieme con il nostro fratello Antonio, andare incontro a Cristo quando Egli, che la nostra vita apparirà nella gloria. Father, in your hands we commend our brother Antonio. We are confident that with all who have died in Christ, he will be raised to life on the last day and live with Christ forever. We thank you for all the blessings you gave him in this life to show your fatherly care for all of us and the fellowship which is ours with the saint in Jesus Christ. Lord, hear our prayer. Welcome to our brother to paradise and help us to comfort each other with the insurance of our faith until we all meet in Christ. Be with you and with our brother Antonio forever. We ask this through Christ our Lord. Thank you.